Hi everybody, this is Patty with A Soul's Heartbeat, and I'm here today with my first design team project for my creative spirit. Clare had sent me in my welcome box the A5 notebook holder set and two of the Stamperia Imagine journals that go in, and I'm going to show you what I did with them today. The Stamperia, this Imagine paper, is gorgeous, and I'm sorry I don't have the whole thing because I've cut it up in so many bits and pieces, but this is kind of an overview of what it is. It is the Imagine, and this is what it looks like. It is so pretty. I love, love, love playing with it. So this is what I've made. I am so happy. I'm really happy with how it turned out. It's a little stiffer than what I had anticipated, but that's okay. And my wrapper is a paper bag, just a plain paper bag. Now, you get like lunch bags like this, and they come all folded up. What I did was I pushed it out and made the bottom flat and made it down so it makes like this. And that only that I turned it this way so that everything would fit right. Now, I'm going to have a video showing how I made the wrapper, the whole process from start to finish. I'm not going to show how I did the journal that's inside because that's one of Clare's kits. I will put the link to it below the video so you can check it out and see if it's something you'd like. These are wonderful, let me tell you. These are absolutely wonderful. They go together fast with her, where's my tape? With her black tape, construction tape around the outside. Oh, so good. My wrapper was, like I said, a paper bag. And I covered it with all kinds of bits and pieces of tissue paper and old music paper, some dictionary paper, and I used Mod Podge on it. Then I went over it with elements from the paper. Like all of these are elements from the Stamperia paper and this dream and this, and went over it again. And because it has so many coats of Mod Podge on it, it got stiffer. If you were just doing it with the tissue paper, it's real thin and flexible and movable, but that's okay because this, oh, it's just something so different from anything I've done before, and I'm truly, truly in love with it. So I hope you will check out my process video because maybe this is something that you would like to try. And like I said, you can use any size paper bag, just cutting it down. And I actually had to cut the flap off here and attach it here because I couldn't find a bag that was quite the right dimension. So I have a little pocket on the back and one of the cutouts from the paper with this little tag. And I thought whoever purchased this, if they were going to give it as a gift, they could write to and from, or if they were going to keep it for themselves, they could put the date for the journaling inside as to whatever the date was. I've covered it with all kinds of the Stamperia paper from that Imagine set and done a heavy coat of the Mod Podge on it. Here, let me flip my flap out. Here, I made a pocket and put another tag in it, and this is from the paper. Art must be an expression of love, or it is nothing. I have two little charms on it. One says handmade, and the other says made with love, and these are metal charms. And the back of the tag is made from all the little scraps that I tore off from this, and it says made with love. So that's that. Now you simply just pop this open, pull your journal out, and this is the inside. And I want to show you that it's completely finished inside. Only most of the inside, if you can see here, is just my tissue paper and scraps because I didn't want to use up my good Stamperia paper. It's hard enough to cut into that when you only have one paper pad. And that is a hint I'm going to tell you. If you buy paper, especially like Stamperia, you only get one sheet of each, and the front and the back is different, so you have to really make a choice or close your eyes and cut and pretend there's nothing on the back. So my advice is always buy two packs, preferably three, because then you can really, you can utilize everything without crying because something got used up because it was on the back side. This is part of the Stamperia paper here. Isn't it gorgeous? And this. But see how well it went with my own music paper and things? And see, this just flips in to hold it closed. And that is my wrapper. Oh, I was so happy. Now, this is the kit that comes from Clare. You get the MDF and the elastic. And mine had black tape. I'd have to look and see. I don't know. I think you have to buy the tape separately. But I'll list the links will be below the video. You also, when you buy this, you get a PDF of the instructions. You also get a link to Clare's video that walks you step by step of how to put this together. And I asked her to send it to me because I liked how hers looked and mine just wasn't coming together that way. And it's amazing when you watch how somebody else does something. It's like, oh yeah, that's how they did it. But I love the look of these. These would make fantastic gifts for people. And it's held together by the elastic cording that goes through the back here. I did choose to cover the spine on mine. And this is a cutout from the paper. And on the back it says, imagination is the reality of the dreamer. Now, I didn't put too much else on this. It's pretty plain, especially for me. But because it goes in my wrapper here, I wanted to make sure that it stayed just as simple as possible so that it didn't hang up and didn't get too big. Now inside are two of the journals that come from Stamperia for this paper line. Aren't they gorgeous? They are a shiny finish paper. Let me get it up there. I don't know if we can see. It's a shiny, it's not the matte like the regular paper is. It's a glossy feel to it. And I did not look to see how many pages are inside of this, but there's a lot of lined paper. And here's the inside and the back cover and the back. And then here's the second one. But oh, these are just gorgeous. Now, wouldn't this be a lovely gift to give someone at Christmas time? This is where I tied for my center. And my others are just, oh, I guess it's this one. The one is tied off here. I did a collage of the papers here from the collection, and I put in some tags here. The paper is so pretty. Now, I did a border on mine, and I'm sorry, I don't have the name of this border. It's a Martha Stewart. It's an old one. But I took and I lined behind it with the black, and then I edged around my cluster with the black. And I didn't line here, and I didn't like how it looked, so I went back with a charcoal pencil and rubbed it in here and along the heart to make them pop out better. But I have another, this was a scrap left from the paper, and I just cut it into a tag shape. And now there is a pocket here besides the big pocket behind. So let's put this one in the front here, and then this one back behind. Then I have another bigger tag here. Is not this paper just absolutely gorgeous? And then these go in like that. And then we flip through our journal, and we flip through our journal, and I have another pocket in the back, which is just one that I folded back, backed with the black, and cut it twice with my circle punch. Love, love, love how this looks. It's just so pretty, clean, classic, and just simplistic, but very nice. I have a bookmark from the paper line. And I have another tag from the paper line. And then I have a piece. Now, this is what I got to tell you. The other side, the opposite side of this is so gorgeous. I had such a hard time deciding which way I wanted it. But pretty soon you just have to close your eyes, glue it down, and forget that there's something beautiful you're covering up. I just backed this with my black cardstock, and I used one of my We Are Memory Keepers corner chompers on that. And that is my project. I absolutely loved it. It was so much fun. I love how this turned out. This is just wonderful. If you're interested in purchasing this, please send me a text message and let me know, or in the comments. I'll try to watch in the comments as well. or you can send me an email. And it just flips in like that, and there we have it. I absolutely am in love. I hope you'll try this. Check out my other video. I'll link to it below, the process video for making the wrapper. I will link to Clare's store and my social media, so you can go over and check out all of her projects. Thank you very much, Clare, for letting me be a part of your design team. Because of COVID and all the restrictions, we had a real late start getting in the year. Doesn't matter. Creativity and happiness can come any time of the year. I think it was even better having it now, because being isolated for so long, it's so fun to have something new to play with. Have a great crafty day, everybody. Enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. Bye-bye now.